Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is Anjeli and I'm back with another video. Today's video, I will be showing you guys how you can add a new bank account or change the old one on your Google AdSense. If this is your first time stopping by my channel, thank you so much for clicking on my video. Please don't forget to like, comment and subscribe, share and hit the bell notification so that you'll be notified anytime I upload a new video. So to begin with, we'll go to Google. But before we start, please make sure you've written your bank account number correctly on a piece of paper, or it will be very advisable if you are using a mobile app for you to copy and paste your bank account. Okay, that one is much safer. So the first thing we'll do is to go to Google and then search for googleadsense.com. Scroll down and click on sign up for AdSense. So here, the Gmail account that you've linked or you used to open or sign up for your Google AdSense, you're going to select the Gmail account. So the next thing to do is to click on the three dashes on the left hand top side, and then you click on AdSense for YouTube. Then you click on the three dashes at the left and top side again. You come down and click on payment. After you click on payment, it then gives you another two options. You click on payment info. So as you already know, maybe you don't know, Google AdSense has now separated AdSense from YouTube AdSense. So we are working with YouTube AdSense. So I'm going to click on the drop down in the box here and then select YouTube. So after you do that, all your payments for YouTube will show. So you scroll down and then you stop at how you get paid. Beneath it is written manage payment method. You click on that. As you can see, I have about three accounts that has been added to my Google AdSense payment. So first of all, I'm going to show you how you can add a new one to your AdSense. So to do that, forget about the other account you're seeing. When you are able to get to this stage, the first thing you see is this box which is written add payment method. So you are going to click on that. So you are given two options as to whether you want to add a new wire transfer details or add new check details. So a little advice for free, always make sure you choose wire transfer, okay, because check details are payments are mostly complicated. I quite remember when I was expecting my AdSense pin for verification for me to start getting paid. It took forever and I had to do it. I had to verify my account manually. And I think this is because of where I am. I stay in Ghana and our postal address is not really developed like the states. So I'll always advise you choose a wire transfer. Wire transfer payments are done directly to your bank account, which no matter where you are in the world, you're going to get paid as far as you entered a correct details for your bank details, especially the account number. So please take note. So I'm going to select add new wire transfer, or you can select check if you please. So after you click on that, you are given other options for you to fill the form. So the first one says beneficiary ID, which is optional, so we are going to skip that. Then the next one says name on bank account. What this means is the name that you used on your bank account, the exact name you used on your bank account. If you are not sure of this, please verify from your bank before you fill these details. So I'm going to enter the name on my bank account. Then the next thing says bank name. What this means is that the bank or the name of the bank you are saving with or the name of the bank you got your account details from or the name of the bank that you would go and withdraw your money when it's being paid from. So I'm going to enter the name of the bank. Then the next one says SWIFT BIC. Mostly you can ask your bank if they are easily reachable, if you can get that information quickly. But also if you can't get that information from them quickly or something, or the bank is far away from where you are, there's no problem, there's another way. All you have to do is go to Google and then enter your bank's name. So my bank, the name of the bank I'm saving with is Ecobank. Then you add SWIFT code. So the country in which you are, you add the country to it. So what this means is that I'm in Ghana, so I want the SWIFT code for Ecobank in Ghana. So I'm going to search Ecobank SWIFT code Ghana. But if you are in Kenya or abroad or wherever you are, you make sure you add your country at the end, because every country have a different SWIFT code. So after that, you are going to search. So the SWIFT code for your country is going to appear here. So then you write it then, or you copy directly from there and then you go and paste. There you have it. SWIFT code is very important, so please take note. So the next detail they need is your account number. Okay, this is where I'm very particular about. Do you know, a friend of mine was filling hers, and instead of she entering the account number, she went to use the number on the ATM card. This can be a number for another person somewhere. So please, whenever you are doing this, check, double check, triple check, check as much as you want to be sure that you are entering the correct account number. So after you enter the account number, you re-enter the account number again for verification. So if the first one you entered, you are very sure it's correct, all you have to do is copy and then paste it to the next one. Okay, so this is just a demonstration. I'm not going to enter any account number over there. So the rest of the information here, the intermediary bank, ask your bank, is optional, and the next one is also optional, so we are just going to skip them. So the last and final thing is set as primary payment method. So what this means is that if you use you put this account over there, and then later on you come and add another one like mine that I have about three over there, you have to set one as very important, as primary, as the first. So what the one that you set as primary, that's the only one that is going to get the payment for that month. So if this is your first bank account that you're adding to Google AdSense, it's very compulsory for you to tick this box, set as primary payment, and then you save. All right, so the next thing is for me to show you how you can change your bank account details on Google AdSense. So what this means is that if you want to edit or change details on your already saved bank detail, all you have to do is that you have to add a new bank details with the correct details you want to correct from the other one. And then when you're done, you set that account or that new one as primary account, and then you delete the one with the wrong information. Yeah. So the next thing is, if you want to remove or delete an account that you've already added, it's so simple. You just click on remove and the account will be deleted. Alright, so that's all to it, guys. If this was helpful, please don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe, and hit the bell notification so that you'll be notified anytime I upload a new video. If you have concerns, confusions, or questions about this video or about something I didn't explain properly, please do well and don't hesitate to ask in the comment section. Have a great week, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye.